Next speaker is Nayan. Nayan has actually made India proud this year because he won not only the BBC prestigious BBC Photographer of the Year, but he also won the World Press Photographer of the Year award, which is probably the most prestigious photography award ever. And we've seen Giri speak about leopards in the forest. We've seen Vidya speak about leopards in rural India. But Nayan's work has been actually leopards in the most one of the most metropolitan city in Asia, Mumbai. So Nayan, can we have you on stage?
Very good afternoon, everybody. Actually, I'm like privileged to show you pictures after Vidya's slideshow. It was a wonderful thing. And I clearly remember, like, way back in 2011, I'll show it to you in my pictures, something happened, and that shifted my focus from birds to leopards. And when I started doing research to get more information on this subject, leopards, because I was totally new to this, I came across Vidya's work, and being born and brought up in Mumbai, like, I know Sanjay Gandhi National Park very well, and Vidya was doing a project in National Park at that time, so I just associated myself with her volunteers, and I got some important information. So I'll just take you through some of the slides, and I will narrate what I learned and what I photographed. My educational background is botany. I'm a freelance lecturer. I did research on birds with BNHS and got fascinated with birds way back in 96, 97. And since then, like for last many years, I was doing bird photography. I had never thought that I would be like trying to photograph big cats, like leopards in particular. And there was this incident that actually happened in Uttarakhand. Vidya has shown this slide. And a leopard was burnt alive. Okay, and that really disturbed me because I was in that area a month before this for a project of mine. And I didn't anticipate this. I mean, villagers can develop that kind of like angry reaction towards an animal, which is totally helpless in the cage. And it really depressed me. I still remember it. It was, I think, 14th March 2011 when this happened, and pictures came out, and it was disturbing. And videos, you can't really see that, like, it disturbs you totally. So I started thinking that what I can do in this, and as I told you before, Vidya's project was going on in SGNP, and unfortunately, 2011 was particularly bad year for leopards. There were many incidents all over India. So in Mumbai, for example, there were leopard attacks, and like there was like negative publicity for leopards in the media and all. And I just wanted to get first-hand idea or the knowledge about this. So I started working on them. Vidya mentioned about a brilliant forest officer over there. So he just asked me to do photography for the park. And in the process, I started gathering information with her volunteers. So this is Mumbai, you might be knowing it, like totally, and this is the national park on the right-hand side, and the city just is eating that thing. That's a stone quarry on the western side. And on the eastern side, you can see that buildings, they are going right up in the national park with all slums and all. So when I started walking over there, I realized that people had some like totally difficult views to, I mean, it was difficult for me to understand that how they were thinking like this. I interacted with all those people over there who had purchased properties over there. And when they bought it because it offered forest view. And when they realized that there were leopards in that forest, they were not ready to accept it. So they wanted forest minus leopards. That was first problem. Second problem was, on like mere sighting of a leopard, they used to complain to the forest department that just capture this animal and shift it back to the jungle. I mean, I interacted with some of the people and they said that we have paid premium to be here and how can a leopard be there in our campus? And it belongs to jungle. And to be fair with them, even I had this kind of idea when I started my work and then I read Vidya's research and all and I realized that, okay, that's not the case. I mean, you might be remembering the one slide that she showed where that collared leopardess was released and it was considering Akole was her house, I mean, the area, and villagers were considering that as their property, and that's why there was that conflict kind of thing. So I started working on them with a group of friends, And without their support, this wouldn't have been possible. Ranjit, Rajesh, Imran, Kunal, they just worked their day and night together with me. And first, believe me, like first 6 months were totally like frustrating kind of thing. Like we didn't see a single leopard, no idea about their movement. And gradually after 6 months, we started finding out the paths. So the territory marking things, and this was taken in 2015. And once we got an idea that, okay, this is how they were moving and about their locations, their patterns, I decided to use this information to create some powerful visuals. Because if you want to carry out awareness, what I believe is that photography has a power to like change the mind if you show a picture in a proper way. So I used this information and I placed my camera traps, I developed them at those locations and I got some pictures, of course, like after a lot of effort, like this, storytelling images. So here you can see a leopard is walking towards Mumbai. That's a slum area. And there is a pig breeding farm over there and it's walking towards that. And like, trust me, getting these images was like really difficult. And I mean, if you leave camera over there, even for a couple of hours, it will be stolen. So I had to wait near camera and guard it. And then I used to sit at, like absolutely motionless and watch the leopards break the beam and all and take its own picture. But then these images, when we started using them for awareness programs and all, it made difference because one image was enough to narrate a story. So I just continued with that, and in the process, we gathered like thousands of images, like many of them. And I had not anticipated this in the beginning, but what I learned was that there were many fascinating ground level stories that were never covered by media at that time. Like it was only negative publicity. And the important thing was, like what I had decided was, wherever the conflict incidents has happened, I would place a camera trap over there for a year at least and would see what happens over there. So that generated a lot of information. And today I'll be sharing two such stories over here, one about a leopard and one about a human being. So my first story is about her. She is Luna, urban leopardess. This is what we learned about her during our camera trapping activities. Actually, we got this image, like first image after 6 months of trial and error. So eventually we got it and she is like totally urbanized leopard. I mean, she lives in Aarey colony in gardens and yeah, it's in Aarey if you go, they keep those saucers for dogs. So in the daytime, dog drinks from them and nighttime leopards, they visit that. I mean, there are benches and I think that image was there with Vidya that it was in the BBC movie, I think. That daytime people are using that and nighttime leopards sleep on those benches. So that kind of thing is happening and here we got her for the first time. And then this was so fascinating because like an average layman, my belief was the leopard belongs to forest and Luna changed it completely because she is a totally urban leopard. She lives in Mumbai city, not in Sanjay Gandhi. She is like total Mumbaikar and yeah. I mean, you will realize why I'm saying this. Totally adapted to the city, you can see JVLR on the backside, that is Powai area, and Luna here with her first cub. She, like, I doubt whether she can hunt a sambar deer or like that. She picks up dogs, rodents, pigs, sometimes scavengers, and totally adapted to that kind of life. I mean, I just, see, we are monitoring her for last 3 years. And you know, when you see an animal over a period of time again and again, you kind of develop emotional connect with that, the way you develop with your pets and all. So when we don't get her in camera traps for like 2-3 days, we become restless that what must have happened to her. And luckily since like 2014 till now, we are regularly getting her in camera traps and she's like, we are totally impressed with her adaptation. So this is Luna in that environment. This is, again, the same animal moving in between the houses in search of dogs. So it's like that. I mean, it happens like that. Now, this is interesting. When we started monitoring her in 2014, she was almost a full-grown cub then. And then we missed her first litter and their development. But second time, I was lucky. We had placed camera traps in series. Because by that time, we knew many things about her. And here she is in estrus. I think it was in February 2016. And she was actually calling and searching for the male. And male was in the national park. So she kept on moving. And we started getting frantic calls from tribal settlements that the leopard is moving boldly. And then eventually we got her in the camera trap and a male after her. And at that time, her first litter was with her. She had kept them aside. So can you imagine this? Two cubs alone in Mumbai, like in the center of the city, where when the mother was actually breeding, and they were in that area. They didn't move. And after 3 days, she joined them again. Like, this is what is happening in the city. And what I believe is that, see, sometimes it scares us because, you know, what might happen? Like, now we have good volunteer network. They are assisting us. But sometimes, like, we just, tend to think like that if somebody complains about this sighting, and then if a cage is put and the animal is captured and it is translocated somewhere else, the poor animal will not be able to survive because it has never seen jungle. It lives in city. Just like that Aquila leopard, Luna considers Aarey as her home. And she never goes in national park. We regularly get her in all those camera traps, and she crosses Goregaon Mulund Road like the way, I find it difficult to cross the road in the busy traffic hours. And she just stops the traffic and crosses the road with her cubs. You will realize that. And then we were exceptionally lucky to get that mating on the camera traps. Here you can see that. This is urban leopard breeding in the center of the city. This was on 16 February. And then equally lucky to get the result. So this is my first story about an urban leopardess where the animal is totally adapted to city habitat. It's like she considers Mumbai as her home. And if you make a mistake and shift her somewhere else, she would probably not survive over there. My second story, daytime cover, she just enters in the forested patch of Aarey or stays near tabelas, it's cowshed area, or just slips inside gardens and all. I'll tell you one incident. I was setting up a camera trap. This image. And I was there where that cub is there, and I was setting up my DSLR trap, checking my flashes and all. I didn't realize that Luna was inside the bush. It was 5:30 in the evening. And once everything was done, I said that let's move out from here. And suddenly, hundreds of crows started gathering over me. And they were circling in the air. And when I looked carefully, I realized that they were looking at a particular direction. So I literally, it was small bush area. So I literally crawled on all four, like up to that distance. And then there was a hairpin bend in the bush. I went there and Luna was sitting 5.5 feet away from me. She must be wondering that what this guy is doing. She didn't do anything. She just looked at me and turned and moved inside the bush again. So totally used to human beings, hasn't done anything, and a wonderful leopard. So my second story is about Ramji. He belongs to Varli tribe of Mumbai. There are some 27 tribal settlements in Aarey. What you can see behind him is the compound wall for one of the tallest skyscrapers over there. And I'll narrate this, what he's indicating. He's pointing towards a place where his son was attacked by a leopard in 2012. This happened on 31st December 2012 due to random translocations. Some other leopard was here. And in 2013, when I went there to meet him, I was surprised, I was taken aback by his reaction. he took me in his house and showed me this, that they had printed invitation card for their son's wedding, and there was a big cat temple in it. And he said that we know our leopards very well, and the animal which has attacked us is not our leopard, it's an outsider. So it was like a remarkable thing. Like, I was totally taken aback. So I decided to place camera traps in his houses, like the way I have done it at many places. And I documented, this was at the same spot which Ramji was pointing, his son was attacked. And I documented 6 different leopards in that lane. So like, these guys were totally comfortable with leopard movement. And then second camera trap was placed opposite side, like here, and both the camera traps were functioning. Actually, I lost the other camera trap after a few months. And this was the second one, same lane. And you can see like what happened in that area, like in the span of 4 or 5 months. So his dogs, that's what the reason why leopards used to come over there, these cats. And I literally cursed them because they used to consume my flash batteries like anything, because every time there was a movement, the camera has to take 5 pictures, 6 pictures. And I was using Energizer lithium batteries, which were very expensive. And sometimes in a night, there used to be like 800 images without a single leopard image. And it happened for consecutive 4 months, and like many such incidents, like during Diwali time, they were lighting lamps. And I have a story over here, and you might have seen my image which got the award, but I missed a better image here. During Diwali time, there were lights along this lane completely, and there was rangoli over here and lights over here. My camera trap was at this place here, and trail masters were behind those poles. And I had asked Ramji that what should be the time setting for the trail masters, and he said that we go to bed by 10:30, so you can switch on your cameras by 10:30 to 5:30. So I did that. On the Diwali day, a leopard walked through that lane at 10 o'clock with lamps on either side and rangoli over here. That would have been an incredible image. But we missed it because camera started after half an hour. So this is what happens in camera trap photography. So his family members moving like that, and their busy activities. And daytime kids, they play in that lane, his grandson and all. And they know that there are leopards in that area, and then eventually you get a leopard over here. So, what this has done is, now, because of this publicity that these images have got, people have started realizing that this is the reality. Like, when this incident happened, when his son was attacked, it became a headline that leopards are doing it. Now the real story is that these guys are comfortable with their native leopards. So that is what I wanted to convey, and that's why this is an ongoing project. It's still going on, and we will discover many more stories like this. So that's all from this presentation. Thanks a lot.